Hello scholars, welcome back to our video 2 of chapter 13, Sun, Moon and the Earth. Scholars, we know that Sun, Moon and the Earth, these are the celestial objects and we see them in the sky. Is it? We see Sun and Moon, but on the Earth we live. Okay, but what happened when these three of them, they come in the straight line? Yes, or do they cast shadow on each other? Let's see. Scholars, here it is the solar system. You can see that the sun is there in the middle and all the eight planets, they revolve around the sun. Now, can you see one fixed path? Can you see the line? Okay. That line shows the fixed path in which these planets revolve around the sun. So, this fixed path in which the planets revolve around the sun is called as the orbit. Now you can see near the earth there is the moon. So, the moon also revolves around the sun in the orbit. So here we can see that the fixed path in which a planet revolves or moves around the sun is called the orbit. Earth revolves around the sun in the orbit, you can see in the picture, as well as the moon orbits around the earth. It means moon also revolves around the earth in the fixed path. So, while moving, the earth, sun and moon, they cast shadow on each other. Yes, they can cast shadow. But when? When they are aligned, okay, or when they come in a line, a celestial body is temporarily hidden by the shadow of another body. And this event is called an eclipse. So, as they come in a line, what happens due to the shadow of one object, the another body gets hidden. And this event, that the hiding of a celestial body because of the shadow of another body, is called as the eclipse. Now, according to the body that is hidden by a shadow, there are two types of eclipses. So, we are having two types of eclipses. Now, from where these two types have come? These two types have come from the body which is hidden by a shadow. First one is the solar eclipse. Now, you can see in the diagram, sun, moon and earth, they are in a line. And when sun is hidden in a shadow, it is the solar eclipse. Yes, so sun gets hidden, okay, due to the shadow of moon, and then it is called as the solar eclipse. So when the moon covers the face of the sun as viewed from the earth, we call it the solar eclipse. The moon's shadow is divided into three portions. You have seen in the previous picture. The first portion of the shadow of moon is umbra. Now what is the umbra? The portion within which the moon covers the sun totally. Then the second portion is the portion within which the moon is in front of the sun completely, but it is very small to cover it up completely. And the third one is penumbra, the portion where moon is in front of the sun, but not completely. So, umbra, penumbra, okay, and third one is portion with which the moon is in front of the sun completely but does not cover it up completely. Yes, so these three are the moon shadow Now let's move to the second eclipse, that is the lunar eclipse. In solar eclipse, we have seen the sun get covered by a shadow of moon. But here in the lunar eclipse, the moon is covered by a shadow of Earth. And then it is the lunar eclipse. In lunar eclipse, there are two shadows, one inside the another. In solar eclipse, we can divide the moon shadow into three portions. But in lunar eclipse, there are two shadows and they are one inside the other. The inner shadow, which is the darker one, is umbra. Yes. We have seen this darker shadow in the solar eclipse as well. So, inner shadow, which is darker one, is the umbra, and the outer shadow, which is faint, it is called as the penumbra. During a lunar eclipse, we can see the shape of the Earth as a circular shadow on the moon. Lunar eclipse occurs only on a full moon day. This lunar eclipse does not have much effect on the Earth, but yes, solar eclipse has. When solar eclipse crosses, the sky goes dark as the sun's light gets blocked by the moon. Since the sun is blocked, uneven heating of the Earth takes place. So, we should follow some precautions while looking for the solar eclipse. First is, we should not look at the sun with the naked eye or directly, and even not to look at the sun through sunglasses, phone camera or binocular. There are some special eclipse glasses or eclipse filters which we should use while looking at the solar eclipse. Otherwise, what will happen, scholars? They will damage our eyes. Yes. So, scholars, I hope you have understood about the difference between solar eclipse and lunar eclipse, and which has the more effect on us, and what precaution we should take while looking at the solar eclipse. Is it? Now, after watching the video, read page number 139 and then draw a neat little diagram of solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. In the next video, we will learn about the satellites. Okay, scholars, till then, goodbye and take care.